anytime somebody gives me something for songwriting, like Songwriting Hall of Fame, Poets Awards, Writers Awards, that's what I was, first and foremost, was a songwriter. I really didn't care about the other stuff. But 99% of the time, if it involves songwriting, I'll show up just because I was a songwriter when I started. And if I wouldn't have had a career as an artist, somebody would have cut my songs. And when it's all over, I'll still have a song in my heart that I'll be working on. That's what I was blessed to do. Yeah, and really the reason they're called bus songs is because we say these aren't songs that you play out very much. You usually just play them in here for your friends. Probably the craziest one that, just because of how it was written, is the song called Ballad of Balad. I landed in Balad, Iraq, and somebody had taken like a piece of plywood and wrote Welcome to Balad like it was the Chamber of Commerce had done it, you know. I seen that sign and I said, Welcome to Ballad. And the driver said, no, sir, it's Balad. And I said, well, somebody needs to write the Ballad of Balad. And so I took off, and between there and the Hooch, I'd written that song. And I was just spouting lyric out and laugh, making everybody laugh on the bus. And in 20 minutes, I'd written the whole song. It just fell out of the sky. It's about a guy that's kind of a do-no-good kind of a guy, kind of a slacker. And, you know, he quit school. He grows out his hair. He's working in a lawnmower repair shop. And he's at the Winn-Dixie shopping. And a guy walks up and says, I'm an Army recruiter. And he basically says, you know, show you the world, I'll teach you a trade, you need to come go with me. And he gets there and he says, you didn't tell me I was gonna get my ass shot at. And they just laugh at it, because it's probably true to some of those guys that were recruited. Show you the world, we're gonna teach you a trade, we're gonna pay you, you make lots of money, but they never tell you that you're gonna get your ass shot at. And that's the humor in it. First year or two I went in, it was a little nerve-wracking. And I saw what a void we filled when we went. And so I thought, you know what, I can give 2 weeks a year. And I did it for 11 years and over 200 shows. The very first night in Iraq, we landed. It was 120 degrees at 9 o'clock. And they took us to Camp Cook on a helicopter. And then was bringing us back to Camp Victory in Baghdad. And the chopper we were on got called away to a firefight to go pick some guys up. And they set us down at a barn in a field at midnight and left us there. And so there'd be a chopper from Camp Victory to come get you here in about 30 minutes. We didn't have weapons or nothing. Yeah, I was scared. Well, in about 20 minutes, a chopper came and got us. And each year, I learned to trust them more and more. And by the third or fourth year, we were going wherever they told us to go. You're willing to volunteer and go do that job that your country asked, right or wrong, I don't care. I support them when they're not at war, too. So, country says you go, they don't have to sign up and go do that, and they do it anyway. It's an uncommon valor that deserves all of our respect. As long as we got evil in the world and we have people that are willing to go defend it or defend right here, it's awesome. So they deserve it.